again same doGet and doPost method. Here, same doGet and doPost method is here. Now I want to call this admin home servlet if user ID and password is correct. And in this code, we just print the login success and login fail. But I want to divert the execution to admin home.java, that servlet, if user ID and password is correct. So here, instead of printing the success message, I want to call the another servlet. Another servlet name is admin home.java. And here in the doGet method, I'm printing a welcome message. Then try it up. Then now question is that how we can call the another servlet admin home from here. So for invoking the another servlet, we need to call one function that is belongs to response. So in the doGet and doPost, there is the two parameters there. HTTP servlet request object we already used it to retrieve the values from HTML file, right? This methods request.get parameter, and this is the name of a text field. And now I want to divert this execution from this page to another servlet code. So response object is used. This response object I'm using here, response dot method name is send redirect. In this send redirect method, we can pass the parameter which page you want to open, admin home. Okay, we never pass any extension here, dot java dot class, only the servlet name. So when user ID and password is correct, then it will divert the execution to admin home. Let's check. Is that clear?
Yes.
Because it's stop. The port conflict is there. Today I installed one new software on my laptop, that's why port is occupied.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm using MySQL instead of Oracle. I'm okay. Changing the port. Thank you. So new user ID password is admin admin. Asking for the driver, so we need to add zar file. SQL connector, let's copy and paste in the lib directory. Unknown column user ID and where class. Yeah, its column name is UID. So it divert the execution on admin home. Now this is the way how we can call one servlet from another servlet using response.sendDirect method. So this method directly divert the execution from the servlet to this servlet name which we have passed here as a parameter. Now in the admin home, I want to store some employee information. So I need to create one more form, employee ID, name, address, phone number and all this. So in this application which we have created, there are two type of pages is there. First one is a static page. This HTML is a static page because its content is always static. Okay, but the hello servlet and admin home, this is the dynamic page. Okay, so when we develop any web application, only one static page is there. That is the first page. Just like facebook.com, Gmail, first page is static. Because we want fast response. HTML is executed fast as compared to servlet, JSP, .NET and PHP. So that's why first page must be HTML page. And other page is dynamic pages. So I want to create one employee form, but there is no, I will not create HTML page. I will write all the HTML tag inside the output println. So for creating a new form, means employee ID, name, address, phone number, all form, we need to write all these HTML tag which we have write here, this form tag, just like we need to write this all code. I can't write directly this HTML code in the doGet and doPost method. Obviously it will give the error because JVM or Java C compiler doesn't understand what is this form tag. So we need to write all this HTML code inside Java code. So correct syntax for creating a form here, we need to write inside out.println. Then double quotes is already there, so we need to write double quotes here. Close this output printer. No, every code means every HTML code will be must write inside the Java code. ID is text field, name is also text field, mail ID is text field Xander. In the Xander, I want to use a radio button. So for creating radio button in HTML, we need to write input type radio. City for city drop down, for getting a drop down select tag is used. So problem with servlet is only is this: we need to write all the HTML code inside Java code. That is a problem. Mm-hmm. So that is a need of JSP. Means why JSP is means the JSP will do the same thing, but difference is that this is the limitations of, this is the disadvantage of servlet. We need to surround all this HTML code inside the Java code. So it's a tightly dependency between designer and developer. In the companies, two different person is there. Designer is different and developer is different. Okay. Developer knows how what is use of do get, do post and all the Java code. Designer only knows this HTML code. So servlet provide one dependency of designer and developer. So to overcome this dependency, JSP is coming after servlet. So firstly, I am writing this code in servlet, after that I will convert into the JSP. For address text area, at last form tag is closed. Okay. So this form is completed. Now check. Yeah. It's complete form comes in the single line. So we need to change the line. So for changing the line in HTML, br tag is there, break rule. Mm-hmm. So I can either we can use br tag here. I want to change the line here. So we can use br slash. So it will change the line. But I want to show the form in the same manner in which I align here. So means if I provide a space here, means as per the coding I want to align, I want to provide the alignment in the output window, okay, here. So for this purpose we use pre-tag PRE. Just open the pre-tag before first component and close this pre-tag after last component. Check it's working or not. So as per your alignment in the code, that same output will be reflected on the output. If I put a space here, then it will give the space in the output. So it's just simply look like a HTML form, but it's not a HTML form. It's a servlet code. Okay, and this HTML code is written inside the Java code, servlet code. Now same, I want to store this information into the database. So as the same execution will be go in the action tag, action form. When we submit this form, then execution, it will check that what is the name in the action, hello solid. So it divert the execution to the hello solid. In the same manner, when we submit this form, then it will check what we write in the action. So here I need to write another servlet name, insert emp. So now I need to create this insert emp.java new servlet. Insert emp.java. Now same here we have write post, method equals to post. So we need to write all this code in the doPost method. So here we will retrieve all the data from that inquire form using request.getParameter method. This is a variable name and this is the text field name, so both name may be different. No need to write the same name. Sender safety address. Same method for tagging the input on every type of component. So we retrieve all these values from the HTML form. Now we need to add the same JDBC code, and using insert statement we will insert this code, insert the data into database. So same class.form name and prepare statement. Firstly we need to import the SQL package. Its query will be insert values. And total number of values is 6, so we need to ask 6 question mark. Here on the first question mark is for employee ID, and here when we creating the table, firstly we need to create the employee table. Salary is already there, no salary here. we will drop this column salary worker table, empty, drop column salary. ID name, then mail ID is Ender. We need to write to instead of item table, I am creating a new table. Create table null.
And address the varchar spelling mistake.
Yeah, varchar mistake. Before city. There's a six column here. So first column data type is integer and remaining is a string. So we need to pass integer value here, and here EID is a string. So we need to convert this EID string into the integer. So for string into integer method is integer dot parse. It will convert the string into the integer.
Mail IDs.
Yeah, mail IDs. All the question mark is filled. Execute this statement. Table name is employee. Thank you. So it divert the execution to inside EMP. This message there. So it will store all this input. So in the servlet, we need to write means all the core Java code, all the JDBC code will be write inside the doGet and doPost method. Now when we need to write the code inside doPost method, so obviously our executions is coming from the HTML page, and in the HTML form we have used right here method equals to post. That's why in the insert EMP servlet we need to write all this JDBC code in the doPost method. Okay, but here we have write the code in the doGet instead of doPost in this page, because in this is the admin home page, and this admin home page is we are calling from response.sendReact method. Okay, we are not calling this admin home page from the form tag, okay, HTML form. That's why we write all this code in the doGet. So if your execution is coming from form tag, then that time we need to write all this code in the doPost method. And if you directly calling using sendReact method, then obviously we will write all this code in the doGet method. So this is a default method. DoGet is automatically called when we use the response.sendReact method. So problem is that this is a totally dependency of designer and developer, because this is a page is designed by the designer, and designer doesn't know what is Java and where he doesn't know what is output println. So if designer want to check that this form is created fine or not, means it's working or not, so it totally depends on the developer. Developer will compile this code and deploy in the Tomcat server and open the web browser and type the URL. After that, designer able to see how form will be looked after executions. So these are tightly dependency between designer and developer. So to remove this problem, Java provide new technology, that is JSP. Java server pages. So first difference between both, the extension. In the servlet we generally save our file with the .java extension, but in JSP we will save our file with .jsp extension. JSP stands for Java server pages. And second, HTML code inside Java code here, but JSP is just opposite of servlet. Here we will write Java code inside HTML code. So it's totally depend independency with designer. Tightly dependency between Java developers and HTML designer in the servlet, but here nothing, no such type of dependency. And if there is a designing issue, so it will take too much time. Means suppose one designer write here, I want to write one image here in this form. So designer, for adding one image here, we need to write image tag img and src, and here we need to write the name of image, any name, jpg. Now how designer will test that this image is working or not, is displaying on the web browser or not? So it totally depends on the developers. Designer is totally depend on developers. Developer will execute this code, and suppose when this developer execute this code and image is not displaying, so this problem is, this is a designer problem or developer problem? Okay. Designer will, we can't say that, because designer write this right code. This is a correct code for displaying the image on the web browser.
Mm-hmm.
So that is a very, it will take more time for resolving this type of designing issue. That is a problem. And this type of problem never come in the JSP. How we use this, how will you resolve this type of problem in the JSP? Let's see. So in the JSP, firstly, designer design the, if I want to design the same page in the JSP, and if I want to write Java code, so we need to learn some tags. In the JSP, we need to learn these three tags. JSP scripting element, directives, and action tag. First is a scripting element. If you want to declare any variable, so declaration tag is there. The syntax is percentage not and closing with percentage greater than. I am creating one JSP page here. Just right click. and here is the option JSP file. So this is a HTML port, only we save, rename this port. Suppose this is a HTML file and we just rename this file. We remove this HTML extension and we just write the instead of .html, we save as this file with .jsp extension. So designer first design all this HTML code and it will save with this page with .html extension. Okay. After that, it will double click on HTML page and he will test that all the designing code is perfect or not. And if all this code is good, then he delivers all this HTML page to the developer. Developer will rename this file. Rename this page with he remove this .html and just write .jsp, and between this HTML tag he will write the Java code. So for variable declaration tag is there, syntax is not, percentage not, and here we can declare a number of variables simultaneously. We can't directly write here in x because it considered as a data and it will print it exactly same as on the web browser if I execute this. So JSP provides this type of tag for declaring a variable. We need to declare all these variables inside this tag. Less than percentage not and closing with percentage greater than. Let's say I am executing this code. So this is JSP. So we can't write in text directly. So declaration tag is there. If I write outside the declaration tag, then it will not consider this is we are declaring integer variable. So we need to write inside this declaration tag. Now I want to perform the addition of these two number. So there is a second tag is expression tag. Expression means a statement that returns some value and it doesn't contain semicolon. And it will calculate, means it will return some values and as well as it will print the values. So I want to print here addition of x plus y. So simply write percentage syntax is equals to and x plus y. So then now when we execute this code, it will print at 30 on the web browser. So this is expression tag. Now third tag is scriptlet. This is the scriptlet tag which we can write any type of Java code. If you want to write JDBC code, then we can write. If you want to write loops and any core Java code, we can write in this expression tag. Here we can also write output printlm. Suppose I want to print the values of x plus y once again. So we can directly use output printlm x plus y. So it will print at 30 here and again it will print at 30. So between HTML code we can write our Java code using these three tags. Now I want to print date, system date and time. So we need to import the package. So how we can import the package in JSP? For importing the package in JSP, after these are scripting elements, so three, declaration tag, expression tag and scriptlet. After that JSP directive is there. In the JSP directive, two type of directives there, include directive and page directive. Page directive is used for importing the package in JSP and include directive is just a name. It will include the content from another file. So page directive I am using here for importing. I want to import the util package. I want to print the date, system current date. So the syntax for importing the package, at the rate page import and here java dot date. I want to import one more package, so no need to write this line once again. Just press comma, separate it with the comma. We can import n number of package here. So this is a way how we can import the package in JSP. Now I want to create object of date class. And here D. Schedule printed date and type. So this is a way how to import the package. Now second directive is include directive. It will it used for including the content from another file. Suppose here we are printing the additions of x and y, and suppose x and y variable is not here, obviously it will give the error, undefined symbol x and undefined symbol y. Suppose this x and y declaration is right in another JSP page. So one more JSP page is there. Name is e.json. Yeah, one more thing, there is no necessary condition to write HTML code inside JSP page. We can only write a Java code, that it's also working. Means HTML code is not compulsory to write in JSP. So this is the a.jsp in which we have declared the x and y variable, and another file newfile.jsp in which we are using that variable. Obviously it will give a compile-time error because in it finding the where x and y variable, so it giving the error x cannot be resolved to variable. So when I including the content of a.jsp, then obviously this code automatically included here and it find the declaration of x and y. So for including the content, %@ include file. The file name is a.jsp. So when I am writing this code, then error is automatically resolved. So it include the content and I write this line a.jsp. Then obviously never do that. So include directive is used for including the content from another page to our page. So this is a simple tag which we generally used for developing a website.
For the image sources, we will use include, right?
What?
For image.
Yeah, image included image source. The image name, suppose images, image. You need to place in the same. I'm creating a new folder, name of image. Inside this image, our image is stored here. In the image folder, only java.jpg. We'll write here image slash name of image.
Okay, it is setting the same as HTML, not in JSP, right?
Yeah, it's the same. Actually, JSP is nothing but it's a combination of core Java and HTML.
Okay.
So you need to write all this core Java code in this tag, explicit tag or declaration or expression. Okay. Suppose I want to show this image 5 times in my page. Okay, I am using some smaller image. I suppose this is the image. Image name is error.jpg. Now I want to show this image five types. Five. I want to show the five image here. So if HTML designer will simply copy and paste to this image src code five times. So it will obviously display image five times, right? But I don't want to write image. So we just surround this code in the for loop. Okay. Now let's see. We need to write the skiplet tag. For now for loop body is started here and not closing. Image tag means all your HTML code will be write outside this skiplet tag, because this skiplet is tag is only used for Java code.
Oh.
And just closing the bracket, again open the, obviously curly break is a part of Java code, so we need to place this curly break in the skiplet tag. And see here, body of for loop started here and ending here. And between this body, image src is there. So this is the way how JSP we can use. This is the five. Okay. Mm-hmm. So when you see here, right click and just go in the view page source. So it will show that you have used five times image source. Because from the web browser, we can't access dynamic code. Okay, we can only access the static code. This is a static code, HTML code. So when you open any website and just right click on website, and when you view the page source, then it will show only static code. This is the static code. So we didn't write this code in our JSP page. We simply printing out object of date class. Then it will print the date. But here, when we right click and show the page source, then it will show all static code. So all the Java code will be comes in this skiplet tag, and all the HTML code write outside this skiplet tag. That is the syntax for JSP. Okay, now I am creating one applications using JSP, Servlet, and JDBC.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm creating a separate project.
So if you want, if you want to include another JSP file in the same one, we need to use include, right? Include file.
Yeah, include items. Okay. Yes, yes. Include file. One more thing is there. Action tag is also there.
Mm-hmm.
This is the action tag. This is also used for including the content and include and forward. See, these two examples. Include these are include directives.
Okay.
These include directives will include the content at compile time. It will include the content at compile time. Means we are using x and y variable here. This is, and x and y is not declared in this page. X and y variable is declared here. So at the compile time, it automatically including the content.
Okay.
Now I want to include the content at runtime. So for including the content on runtime, we generally use include action tag.
Mm-hmm.
So I am creating one more JSP page. B.JSP. And I want to include all the content of A.JSP page, means new file.JSP, this image and this date and all this stuff. I want to include in this b.jsp, but at the runtime, not compile time. So for this purpose, we generally use include action tag. So difference between both is that this include action tag include the content at runtime, and include action, include directives include the content at a compile time. So syntax is jsp include page, another page name is new file. Now executing this b.jsp file. It will give the same output, because it includes all the content from A.JSP. So it's contents coming from A.JSP, but printed on the B.JSP, right? So it includes the content at runtime, not compile time. And include directives include the content at compile time. So that is the difference. This action tag include the output, not source code, okay, not code. And include directives include your source code, not output. So source code means compile time and output means runtime. Now I want to call one JSP page from another JSP page. So suppose one more page is there, c.jsp. This is the important concept, how to call one JSP from another JSP. This is c.jsp page. This is a c.jsp. I want to call this c.jsp from b. So a syntax is how we can call one JSP from another JSP. So in the servlet we already gone through one method, response.sendDirect. So in the scriptlet we can directly call response.sendDirect and name of another page is c.jsp. We can directly write here. Okay, in JSP we need to write the extension here, but in the servlet we never write extension right here. We only write the name of servlet. Okay. So when I executing this code, this is the code written in the b.jsp and I am invoking the c.jsp. See what happened. So when I executing b.jsp, then it automatically divert the execution to c.jsp. Yeah, c.jsp, and this is the C page. Clear. So response.send, if I write here google.com or facebook.com, www.fb.com, so directly open the Facebook. v.jsp, then when this method is executed, then it will open the Facebook. Okay. So response.sendDirect directly open that page. Now instead of using this response.sendDirect, second way how to call one JSP from another JSP. So option is forward method. Forward action tag is there. So syntax is JSP colon forward page JSP, page which I want to call c.jsp. That's it. Now this this is the code which is written inside the b.jsp and I am trying to call c.jsp. Now see in the output. See what is showing in the URL b.jsp, right? And it opened the page c.jsp. So that is a secure technique. Means forward is much better than response.sendDirect because it's more secure. Because when any hacker want to hack this, it will check that what is the name of page b.jsp, but when it's go on hack the b.jsp page, then nothing will be there.
Hello.
Yeah, Pratyusha, is that clear? Difference between redirect and forward. Okay.
Yeah.
Only difference is after invocations of send redirect method, URL will totally change, but after executions of forward method, URL doesn't change. So that's why forward method is more secure than redirect. Okay. So I think it's enough for today's session. We will develop one small project using JSP, Servlet, and JDBC in the next session.
Okay.
Just try to write. Okay.
Mm-hmm.